Hi everyone, this is Claire, and today I'm going to bring you on an adventure on Plum Island with me. I'll be looking at some salt marshes and also at some beaches and telling you about the plants that I'm finding along the way. It's still, of course, very early in the season, so we will see what we can find. And I hope you enjoy coming on this little adventure with me. Now, you can't see them right now because they've died off for the winter, but they'll be back. Is the two most common grasses around here are Spartina alterniflora and Spartina pings. All right, what we're seeing here in the foreground, waving very beautifully in the wind, is Phragmites. Phragmites is an invasive, actually. The stuff is all dried out, so it's not currently alive, but it'll come back once the growing season starts. Phragmites forms a monoculture, so the areas that it grows in, it blocks out everything else that grows. What you're looking at right there, the pile of hay with the legs sticking out of it, is called a staddle. Now, staddles were used to store hay as it was harvested before modern technology. The hay was harvested by hand using scythes, piled up on there by someone standing on the top of it who would kind of pile it underneath them, and then when they were done and it was very, very tall, he would slide off into a flip, and then the hay was transported by horses, which had to wear special shoes so they wouldn't sink into the marsh. This right here is some very old staghorn sumac. And staghorn sumac got its name because you can kind of see here that it's a bit red and it's a bit soft, and it reminded people of the velvet on the antlers of deer and those sorts of animals. Now this right here, for the most part, is dune grass. Dune grass, as you might guess by the name, lives on sand dunes. And one of the really interesting things about it is it has really deep roots. They go down as far as a couple dozen feet in order to get to water, since sand doesn't hold water very well, and they really need to get down deep to get to where the water table is. Currently on the dunes and the beaches in the distance, and you see all these plants, they have a really important purpose when it comes to the dunes, because the dunes are made of sand, and obviously they would blow away given the option. So all of the root systems from all of these plants are really important for preventing the beach from eroding. They create a buffer against the ocean and the sand and the wind. I hope you enjoyed coming on this little adventure with me and enjoyed seeing the plants that I was able to find. Thank you so much for watching. If you'd like to subscribe, please hit the subscribe button, and I'd love it if you hit the like button. I've also included links to merch and my website where you can find a bunch of learning resources. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.